good morning. It surely is a great day. Good morning and welcome to the 58th commencement ceremony for Lane Community College. I am Stephanie Bolger, president of Lane Community College. I will be serving as your host for today's ceremony. We start with the acknowledgement that the college rests on traditional homelands of the Kalapuya people. The Kalapuya were stewards of this land for over 14,000 years before their traditional way of life was forever disrupted and destroyed. As we celebrate our graduates today, let us also acknowledge our responsibility to learn from the effects of racism and white privilege on all people of color. At this time, I invite you to stand as you are able, as members of the Lane Community College Public Safety presents the colors, and Kate Ferguson leads us in the national anthem. And after the national anthem, then please feel free to have a seat.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still.
Let's give Kate Ferguson and the Color Guard another round of applause. And thank you both. That was a beautiful way to start today's ceremony. Graduates, we have many guests with us today to join in your celebration. At this time, I would like to introduce our guests and invite them to stand or otherwise allow us to recognize you when I call your names. Audience, please hold your applause until all of the names are called. Dr. Shelley Tinkham, Vice President, Academic Affairs. Dr. Coleman Joyce, Vice President, Student Affairs. Rosie Pryor, LCC Board of Education Chair, and Board Members Mike Eister and Austin Fonagy. Honorable Peter DeFazio, our keynote speaker. Nikar Rumlakin, President, Associated Students of Lane Community College. Laura Pelletier, Communications Faculty. Crystal Platt, our distinguished alumni. Our very special guest from Togo. Mr. Frederic Adem Hegbe, Ambassador of the Country of Togo to the United States. Mr. Gervais Zogbama, Director of Scholarship Program for Ministry of Higher Education, Government of Togo. And in the audience, Mr. Awoke Kwenzi, Government of Togo, and Mr. Sarafa Adeoye, Particular Secretary of the Minister of Higher Education and Research. Please join me in giving all of our guests a warm Titan welcome. Thank you all for being here today. You may be seated. Graduates, friends, and family, on behalf of Lane Community College, again, it's my pleasure to welcome you to the 58th annual commencement ceremony. In a few minutes, students will become newly minted graduates of this college. You will forever be the best that Lane Community College has to offer. You will become a part of our most successful alumni. It is my privilege to host this ceremony to honor your accomplishment. Today is about you and your future, and still, you could not do it alone. So let's give another big Titan thank you to all of your family and friends who supported you these past years. Family and friends, please stand up, family and friends, as you are able to be recognized. Please stand up, family and friends, as you are able to be recognized. And you could not do it without your faculty, teaching you, learning from you, and providing you guidance and opportunities. Faculty, please stand as you are able, and let us all thank you for putting students first. Students, the map of your journey here was made clearer because of your advisors, coaches, counselors, tutors, and all of the professional staff at Lane that care about your success. Please join me in thanking the professional staff, and if you could please stand up as well to be recognized, all of the professional staff in the audience. And now, at this time, I invite you to join me in welcoming the 2022-2023 Board Chair, Rosie Pryor, to give greetings from the Board of Education.
Honorable Ambassador, Congressman DeFazio, President Bulger, graduates, families, faculty and staff, it is my honor and privilege to stand before you today in my last formal role as chair of the Lane Community College Board of Education. I am proud to have played a small part in your journey, and I'm excited to see where your future takes you. I want to begin by congratulating the class of 2023 on your incredible achievement. Your dedication, hard work, and perseverance have paid off, and you have earned your place here today. This is a class that has achieved great things and has left an indelible mark on our institution. They have worked tirelessly to reach this moment, and they have demonstrated their resilience, their intelligence, and their determination. It has been our privilege to bear witness to your success in and out of the classroom. This class has embraced diversity and inclusion. They have fostered a community that is welcoming. They have challenged themselves academically and personally. They have shown that Lane Community College is a place where students can thrive and learn and succeed. But the journey doesn't end here. As you close one chapter of your life, a new one is set to begin. You are now, or you're about to be, alumni of Lane Community College, and you have the tools, the knowledge, and the skills to succeed in the world. Remember, success is not always measured in material wealth or social status. Rather, it's about the impact you make, the lives you touch, the people you inspire. As you move forward, I challenge you to continue learning, continue growing, and continue striving to make a positive difference in your community It was Winston Churchill who said, "Success is the ability to go from one failure to another with no loss of enthusiasm." I've served 12 years on the Lane Community College Board. This is my last commencement. As I conclude my term, I have a profound sense of optimism for the future of Lane Community College. My hope is that you will always remember this place as a stepping stone to greater opportunities. Take what you've learned here and apply it to whatever comes next. Continue to aim high, persist through challenges, and never stop learning. So, to the class of 2023, congratulations again on your outstanding achievements. Celebrate today, but remember, this is just the beginning. You are prepared for what lies ahead, and we are confident that you will continue to make us proud. On behalf of the entire Lane Community College Board of Education, we wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Board Chair Pryor. Faculty, staff, friends, and family, it is now my honor to introduce you to our graduating class this year. Graduates, you are one of 1,120 members of the graduating class of 2023. And collectively, you've earned 1,886 associate degrees and certificates. 54% of you completed associate degrees to transfer to a university. 47% have earned a career technical degree or certificate, and 69% of you will have more than one award conferred. 4% of you are veterans receiving veterans benefits. Please stand as you are able so we may thank you for your service if you are a graduating student veteran. Thank you. Thank you very much. 20% of you earn credentials in one of our advanced technology areas. Another 20% of your credentials are in the areas of the arts or social sciences. About 10% of you earn credentials to work in IT, business, and accounting fields. 6% of you are soaring high with credentials earned from the Lane Aviation Academy. 36.6% will be working in healthcare careers, including dental hygiene, nursing, paramedicine, and more. And Lane helped you get the funds you needed for college. 51% of you used Pell Grants. 22% used Oregon Promise Grants. Please join me in thanking our elected officials who work to keep those funds there for you. College is not easy when you're the first in your family to attend. 53% of you are the first in your family to go to college. And age was no barrier this year. Your ages span over 50 years. The youngest graduate is 15 years old, and our oldest is 72. There are 8 graduates under age 19, and 5 graduates will be 60 or older as of this commencement. The average age of graduates is 28 years old. You proved yourself inside and outside of the classroom. The average GPA was 3.39, and 47% of graduates have a GPA of 3.5 or above. These are our honors graduates. Please give them a round of applause. Graduates, one of your biggest supporters is here today, your student government president, Nikar Rumlakin. Nikar Rumlakin, an international student from Johannesburg, South Africa, moved to Eugene in 2021 to study computer science at LCC. During his time at LCC, he has been the student body president for the 2022-2023 academic year and represented associated students of Lane Community College on the College Council. Nakar also served on the Board of Governors for the Oregon Student Association, advocating for student needs. He briefly worked as an international peer mentor and collaborated with Lane's international programs. A member of the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, he will transfer to the University of Oregon in the fall to pursue a degree in computer science. Please join me in welcoming student government president and 2023 LCC graduate, Nakar Remlakhan.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, faculty, staff, Board of Education members, members of the cabinet, families, but most importantly, to the graduating class of 2023. My name is Nakar Remlakhan, and it is an honor to stand before you today as your 2022-2023 student body president. As I sat down 3 days ago to craft this graduation speech, I couldn't help but be struck by the significance of the date. June 14th holds a deep personal meaning for me as it marked the 4-year anniversary of triumphing over a life-threatening bone cancer diagnosis. As I look back at to where my journey began 4 years ago, I'm reminded of the whirlwind of emotions and uncertainties that consumed me. At the time, the thought of leaving home and embarking on the path of higher education whilst navigating a foreign country on my own was unimaginable. My focus was solely on my health and fighting for my life. But life has a way of surprising us and can take us on unexpected detours that lead to unimaginable destinations. I reflected on this challenging period 3 days ago, and I realized how much my life had transformed over the course of 4 years. It was a realization that sparked a newfound appreciation for the journey I had embarked upon. However, as I stand here today, I recognize that my journey is not unique. Each one of us has experienced our own trials, setbacks, and moments of transformation. We have all faced adversity in various forms, be it personal, academic, or societal, and yet here we are, celebrating this remarkable achievement together. As we reflect on our individual journeys, let us take a moment to consider the diverse paths that have brought us to this very stage. We come from different backgrounds, cultures, and walks of life. Some of us have battled personal hardships, faced financial constraints, or dealt with the pressures of balancing work and education. Others have navigated the challenges of being a first-generation college student or adapting to a new country. Each one of us has our unique story, filled with triumphs, struggles, and moments of growth. When I first arrived at Lane Community College, I came in as a traditional student, but in the most untraditional way, as I am an international student from South Africa. Arriving here was the beginning of many firsts to follow. My first international friend, my first American friend, my first time cooking, my first apartment, my first college course, my first college clique, and many other firsts. But most importantly, and for many of the graduates in front of me, it was my first step into higher education. Despite the stumbles and struggles, we persisted and grew stronger with every step, and each step was a stepping stone towards reaching our goals and making our dreams come true. Our journey at Lane Community College and in higher education has also been unique, as we are the graduates of a time marked by unprecedented challenges. We have faced the immense hurdles posed by the global pandemic, adapting to remote learning, navigating uncertainty, and finding resilience in the face of adversity. We have witnessed the power of human spirit and determination as we overcome obstacles that we never anticipated. Today, we stand here as pandemic graduates, a testament to our strength, flexibility, and unwavering commitment to our education. The lessons we have learned during this time will forever shape us, instilling us in the resilience and adaptability that we need to thrive in an ever-changing world. As I reflect on the above accomplishments, I'm reminded of the wise words that my grandfather told me before I was about to move 10,000 miles away from home. Those 3 words were Hindustan Ki Kasam, which metaphorically meant to return victoriously. Today, I'm reminded of those words as I believe that that message is held as I look at the class of 2023, who have all been victorious in their academic efforts and are gathered here to celebrate this momentous occasion, a celebration of achievement, resilience, and dreams being fulfilled. As many of you would know, victory does not often happen alone, and there are a few people in groups I would like to take the opportunity to recognize. I would like to thank our college administration, board members, faculty, and staff for ensuring that we students could thrive at Lane Community College. You have all equipped us with the skills and resources that we need to navigate real-world problems, and we have benefited from your first-hand knowledge and experiences. For my own personal acknowledgements, beginning with my mom and dad, who are watching this from the other side of the world right now, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for everything. Thank you for being my number one supporters in all my endeavors and for providing me with the resources to turn all my childhood dreams into reality by sending me across the world to pursue the American dream. To my brother Nikhil, thank you for keeping me in check and never failing to make me miss our home adventures. To my best friends, Hassan and Ilhan, who went through all the day-to-day activities with me, thank you both for being my family away from home. To my vice president, Amaya, thank you for always ensuring that I was making the best decisions for our student body and for your overall companionship. You truly were the best vice president I could have asked for. To the Lane SGA, thank you for being my on-campus community and the group I spent most of my time working with throughout the year. It has been a pleasure working with you all and watching you all grow into the incredible leaders you are today. On a side note, the Lane SGA would like to congratulate our graduates by awarding all graduates with a gift at the end of commencement. And finally, to anyone else that has touched my life over the last 2 years, you are appreciated and acknowledged, and I thank you for your companionship. To the class of 2023, let us never forget the transformative power of community college education and the impact it has had on each one of us. As we embark on our respective paths, let us seize the opportunities that lie ahead and continue to strive for excellence. May we all be the architects of our own destinies, realizing our dreams and embodying the essence of the American dream. Nothing is impossible, and the only limitation that exists is your own mind. Go forth and make your mark in the world. Lane Community College, thank you for everything, and congratulations to the class of 2023.
Thank you, Nikhar. Thank you for that inspiring message, and thank you for your leadership. Our next speaker, Laura Pelletier, will share the faculty's message for the graduates today. Laura Pelletier is an instructor in communication studies and began her career in higher education in 2009. Laura earned her Master of Fine Arts in Forensics at Minnesota State University and Master of Arts in Health Communication at Washington State University. She is currently completing a Doctorate of Education at Bradley University. She came to Lane Community College in 2017 as a faculty member in the Communication Studies Department and became a faculty division coordinator in Arts and Humanities in 2019. Laura also started and is the faculty advisor for the Delta Beta chapter of Sigma Chi Eta, a communication honors society of the National Communications Association and the only chapter in Oregon. Please join me now in welcoming Laura Pelletier to the stage.
Good morning, esteemed guests, administrators, fellow faculty members, family, friends, and staff. And let's not forget a big hello to the graduating class of 2023. You made it. There are so many things that I, and I'm sure my fellow faculty members would agree, love about our job. Meeting new students, watching those students build a vibrant and supportive community, hearing great student discussions in the classroom, in the hallways, and around campus, and let's not forget those endless hours of grading. But my favorite part of the job is celebrating students, which is why I am honored and pleased to have been invited to speak to you today. I love celebrating students' accomplishments, big or small, like passing that test they thought would be impossible, acing that final paper, getting into their desired program, or getting that job offer. And of course, the pinnacle of celebrating students, graduation. I want you to take a moment and just look around you. Go ahead, it's like a class activity. It's fine. You are surrounded by peers, friends, faculty, staff, administrators, and guests. And we're all here to support and celebrate you. We celebrate you today because you have reached a goal that you set for yourself. And it doesn't matter if you have been here for a term, a year, or a decade. What matters is that you set this goal and you achieved it. You worked hard, maybe struggled sometimes, and maybe even doubted yourself at times, but you persevered and you made it here today. And we are all so proud of you. And more importantly, I hope you are all proud of yourselves. This is a big deal. I want you to remember that wherever you go from here, whether it's continuing on in your education, starting a new career or changing careers, or getting that well-deserved promotion in your current career, know that you are ready, you are prepared, and you have a lot of people in your corner. We know you're determined to achieve whatever goals you set for yourself, and we wish you all the best. Personally, my own wish for all of you is that wherever life takes you, whatever you do, I hope the juice is always worth the squeeze. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Laura. And now we'll recognize four graduates who represented Lane as part of the All-Oregon Community College academic team. I invite them to stand and be recognized, and they are Brandy Green, Jessica Lee, Vivian Norquist, and Annabelle Winningham. Let's give them a round of applause. The All-Oregon academic team recognizes high-achieving two-year college students who demonstrate excellence, leadership, and service. And next, each year we also honor a distinguished alumni at our commencement ceremony. This year we are honoring LCC culinary graduate and James Beard nominee for Best Chef Pacific Northwest, Crystal Platt.
I'm the chef and co-owner of Lion & Owl. Lion & Owl is a brunch restaurant predominantly. We focus on seasonality and farm to table. I had aspirations and dreams of becoming an actress, comedian. I knew that actors worked in restaurants. I had no idea why, but step one is to get a job in a restaurant. I pestered the local owner of the bakery. She finally relented. She let me be a server, and I was awful. She said to me after a few weeks, "I think you'd be better in the kitchen," and I really took to it, like almost instantaneous. I did some research and found the culinary program at Lane and enrolled, and I think it really gave me a really solid foundation and tools and building blocks to then further my culinary career. I really enjoyed the concentration of information, the exposure to all kinds of new techniques and products, terminology. I mean, the whole thing was just like a brand new experience for me. At the time, there was Chef Chris. I really appreciated his stringency and like attention to detail. He gave us those tools to then practice in the Renaissance Room with Clive. Clive was such a jovial, positive presence, very encouraging, kind of made everybody feel like they could do it. Having an opportunity to work in the Wiper Kitchen was fantastic, and it was really great to work in a state-of-the-art facility to practice and hone our skills. The whole scope of the program really did, I think, give me the confidence and the wherewithal to pursue my own dreams of having my own restaurant and own business. Without that, I don't know that I would be here. We are so appreciative of everyone in the community who have come out to support us. We're just so thankful for Lane Community College, and from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. Go Lane. Yeah.
Crystal is co-owner of Lion & Owl with her wife, Kirsten Hansen, who's also here today. But please join me in welcoming Chef Crystal Platt to receive this award. Chef Platt.
Thank you. Yeah.
Our keynote speaker today is the Honorable Peter DeFazio, a native of Massachusetts and a veteran of the United States Air Force Reserve. Peter served as a county commissioner in Lane County prior to serving as the U.S. representative for Oregon's 4th Congressional District from 1987 to 2023. That equals 18 terms, or 36 years. He is the longest-serving House member in Oregon history and the 65th longest-serving member in the history of Congress. I think we need a round of applause for just that. During his time in office, the Congressman DeFazio focused on transportation and infrastructure, environmental issues, veterans issues, and education, among other issues affecting Oregon, leaving behind a legacy of change. One of Congressman DeFazio's proudest accomplishments is contributing funds to 295 scholarships and debt reduction at 5 Oregon community colleges. As of the end of 2020, DeFazio had contributed $466,744 of after-tax salary to scholarship funds. Peter is no stranger to Lane. He's been a regular speaker over the years in political science classes, hired numerous LCC interns and alumni to work in his offices, held countless town hall meetings, secured numerous congressional grants to support our academic programs, and was always there when the college needed a hand with the complexities and challenges of the federal government. To recognize Peter's support of the college and service to our state, the LCC board recently approved renaming the Lane Aviation Academy's main training facility at the Eugene Airport the DeFazio Flight Education Center. A formal ceremony is being planned for later this year, and all of you are invited. So please now welcome to the podium former Congressman Peter DeFazio.
Well, thank you, Dr. Bolger, distinguished guests. Thank you to the friends and family of those graduating today, and thank you to the class for having me here to address you today. It is truly an honor to address this graduating class. You've been through one heck of a lot over your tenure here. You started the journey during a worldwide pandemic. You made it through the challenge of remote learning. Then we had the smoke of climate change triggered wildfires, economic uncertainty, inflation, and this year, I assume that many of you, like me, have suffered through our world record-setting pollen counts. So it has not been easy. It has not been an easy time to get your credentials. But I'm excited to be with you here today. Look out and see our future cybersecurity experts, drone pilots, commercial airline pilots, chefs, restaurateurs, mechanics, teachers, nurses, musicians, tradesmen, tradeswomen, healthcare workers, and more. You have completed demanding programs and you're taking the next step in your lives. You will be prepared and more empowered because of your time here as a Titan. To me, community college students have always acted with a sense of urgency. You came here to change your lives. You came here to change your careers. You came here to earn a credential that will enable you to earn a good living, support yourselves and your loved ones, and realize your dreams. Some of you lost a job, we're starting over. Some of you quit a crummy job that you couldn't stand and came here to make a change. Some of you knew right away what you wanted to do, and you came here to do it. Some of you came here straight out of high school to get a credential in a chosen profession, or because you didn't want to be overwhelmed with the debt it takes to start a four-year university. But all of you acted with dedication and urgency to change your life. And when you make your life better, you make our lives better. More than 90%, this is an extraordinary number, more than 90% of LCC graduates stay in Lane County. That's an awesome statistic. You stay here and get better jobs, pay taxes, start businesses, volunteer, coach kids, sport teams, raise families, help at senior centers, build community, and you will contribute in so many ways to making our community stronger. You have and you will make Lane County, Oregon, and our nation better. As was mentioned, I did represent you all for a long time in Congress, and for many of you, your entire lives before you were born. But I'm also very proud that my successor, Val Hoyle, is a community college graduate. That was her stepping stone up. That says a lot. So when I was first elected to Congress, Oregon was entering a chaotic and complicated time. Thousands of people that worked in the timber industry had lost their jobs. Families across my district were struggling. Public services decimated across the country were barreling toward recession. We had Bush 1 launch the first war in Iraq. We had the savings and loan scandal, which tanked the economy. Of course, that now seems quaint given what Wall Street did to us in 2008 and the policies they keep pushing that enrich the few at the cost of the many. And we faced another problem, inflation, costs going up, jobs going down. So this is a challenging time. And like many of you, I borrowed money and worked while attending college. I knew what it was like to live on a tight budget. I understand the financial challenges that many of you have faced. Working, going to school is hard, especially if you're also supporting a family. So when I got to Congress, as was mentioned, I refused the automatic congressional pay raises my colleagues voted, and especially when our country was operating in a deficit caused by irresponsible tax cuts, bad trade deals, reckless foreign wars, and piling up debt that'll have to be repaid by you and by your kids and by your grandkids. So I decided to do something to help, a little bit. And as was said, I used my pay raises to fund scholarships at LCC and other community colleges in my district, because people who go to community colleges build their community. You work to improve your lives and the lives of those around you. Some of the recipients were changing by choice, but at that time, many in the timber industry were laid off from good-paying jobs and forced to find a new career. So I focused on community college students at that time. They were often people starting over, having had their lives upended by decisions made in Washington, D.C. One quick story. I met one of my first recipients. He had never even finished high school, went to work in the mill in Coquille, had three kids, had a nice house, had a boat, RV. You could make a really good living working in a mill in those days. And then the mill laid him off. That was tough. They struggled through. Then he got hired back. He got laid off again. And he struggled through. He got hired back. Then got laid off again, and he said, I got to do something different with my life. And he decided to go back to school. Remember, he didn't even have a GED. He went to Southwest Oregon Community College. Within 4 years total, he had his master's degree. And he became the superintendent of schools in a little town called Powers, kind of an obscure place in my district. Then he moved to be the superintendent of schools in Ontario, and now he is superintendent of David Douglas High School in Portland, Oregon. And I tell that story because it is the story of community colleges. It unlocks your potential. It unlocked his potential. He could have spent his life in that mill and had, a good living, had the mill kept running, but instead he has contributed much more to the communities he grew up in and to our state and to the nation. And that is what the community college education did for him. So congratulations to you for choosing to start your careers or restart your careers with a community college education. By coming here, you're ready. You're changing your life for the better. You're also improving our country, making our community stronger with everything you do. Your success is our community's success. But let me be clear. Graduation is not the end. It's just the beginning. It's the beginning of a lifelong pursuit of knowledge, growth, pursuit of your passions. It's the beginning of a life where you have the power to make a difference, to shape the world around you, and to leave a lasting impact. As you walk across this stage in a few minutes, remember the countless hours you spent studying, often struggling to stay awake after school, work, or caring for your family, the camaraderie you built with your peers. These experiences have shaped you into the exceptional individuals you are today. Cherish those memories. Carry them with you as you step into the world. But don't let the challenges of today's world deter you. Instead, let them fuel your determination. The road ahead may not always be easy, but there will be moments when you question your abilities. Remember this, you've already proven yourselves capable. You have overcome obstacles, surmounted barriers, and risen to the occasion time and time again. In this rapidly changing world, you possess the tools to adapt, innovate, transform, embrace the unknown, for it is where the greatest opportunities lie. Never settle for mediocrity when greatness is within your grasp. Take risks, think outside the box, follow your passions relentlessly. You are equipped with the knowledge and skills necessary to address the pressing challenges of our time, whether it is the overarching problem of climate change, social inequality, technological advancements, threats to our system of representative democracy. You be the change agents, the advocates, the leaders that this world so desperately needs. Your unique perspectives, ideas, and experiences will shape the future in ways we can't even anticipate. But remember that success is not solely defined by personal achievements. True success lies in the impact we have on the lives of others, in the lives of those we touch, in the positive change that we bring to our communities. Use your education and your talents to uplift those around you and to champion the causes that matter and to fight for a more just and equitable society. Maybe sometimes you might even get in trouble. As my great friend John Lewis, a civil rights leader, said, good trouble to save this nation and move us forward. As you embark on this new chapter, always remember your roots. Remember the support and love of your family, the guidance of your professors, the friendships forged here at LCC. Stay connected and support your alma mater, for this institution will always be part of your story. Today, we celebrate not only your accomplishments, but also the collective potential that lies within each and every one of you. You're the future leaders, innovators, visionaries. The world is waiting for your brilliance, your creativity, your determination to make a difference. Congratulations, graduates. Go forth. Make your mark on the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Honorable Peter DeFazio, for those really inspiring words. And now this is the time you've been waiting for. I'd like to invite our commencement readers to take their places, Dr. Colum Joyce, Grant Matthews, and Ellen Osterkamp. I now welcome Dr. Shelley Tinkham, Vice President of Academic Affairs, to the podium to present the candidates for associate degrees and certificates.
President Bulger, upon the recommendation of the faculty of Lane Community College and by the authority of the Board of Lane Community College, I hereby recommend the conferral of the degrees of Associate of Science, Associate of Applied Science, Associate of Arts, Oregon Transfer, and award certificates to these students.
Thank you, Dr. Tinkham. I am pleased to accept these candidates who, with diligence and honor, have fulfilled the requirements for the associate degree or certificate. At this time, we will present the graduates.
Nikar Ramlikan.
Mimi Francisca Jifa Nouvé.
Karen Jules Streets Sheets Miller.
Lorian Delamuse.
Marcel Degui.
Masood Musa Modi. Yeah.
Rin Shimada.
Derek Hum.
Hina Tamura.
Shoichiro Kamata.
Gruto Susumi.
Owen Gabriel Robles.
Aiden Ang.
Latlun Baihan.
Kao Kant Zhao.
Tuyang Tan.
Len Ten Pai.
Gordon Ho.
Ayumi Sato.
Leia.
Kelly Marie Hoffman.
Abby Williamson.
Cameo Cruz Ramirez.
William McKnight.
Viviana Hernandez Murillo.
Charles Businger.
Kathleen Holder.
Charles Davidson.
Mizuki Takeuchi.
Chen Bonme Suli.
Bone Odd Cant.
Ellie Domingos.
Kana Kunishima.
Yusen.
Kenshin Tuchia.
Adam Sawayama.
Shoyo Harata.
V. Luong.
Nasiba Alpha.
Hinako Miyazaki.
Valerie Nichols.
Grace Richenbach.
Sean Rick Zausel.
Mary Lee Layton.
Thomas Kyle McKnight.
David Davis.
Lacey Wilson.
William Erickson.
Zane Schweitzer.
Zachary Lewis Breading.
Nikki Gilder.
Maria Cristina Cruz Vargas.
Consuelo Guadalupe Portillo.
Cynthia Gutierrez Rodriguez.
Maria Bazan Fabella.
Elizabeth Santiago Curiel.
Carol Long.
Deontay Carter.
Shineye Noli.
Julie Hulbert Routley.
Erica Nicole Jones.
Harmony Todd.
Jonathan Pena.
Angel Aprecio.
Starry Sky.
Ryan McNerney.
Cody L. Dean.
Gracie Mae Schlager.
Yeah. Julio Barrales.
Andrea Webster Banal.
Jasmine Day.
Dustin Anthony Lee Fickle.
Renee Ann Stinson.
Courtney Robinson.
Martin Eduardo Ornelas.
Esmeralda Gonzalez.
Jackie Platez Corrales.
Samantha Esmeralda Alcantar Flores.
Emily Ann Hill.
Michelle Julian.
Ty Potter.
Kaya Gilbert.
Nicole Berge.
Candy Niece.
Alexis Bennett.
Magdaleno Ojeda Yanez.
Maribel Brigido Aguirre.
Alondra Rodriguez.
Grant Sylvester.
Tasia Bryant.
Mary A. Davis.
Sierra Standridge.
Kurt Perini.
Gabriella Lila Ann Mitchell.
Dane Patrick Herman.
Mirabella Olivia Matthews.
Presley June Justice.
Alana Knowles.
Nate James Costco.
Nicole Tucker.
Owen Lundell.
Wilhelm Schlieder.
Brooke Page.
Katrina Lynette Witt.
Samantha Bon Williams.
Andrew Maury Ruxin.
Michael Soliman.
Richard Charles Aldridge.
Isaiah Orion Moreland.
Corey Murray.
Rosa Veronica Campos de Frugé.
Matthew White.
Savannah Marie Wilson.
Rebecca Faith Puterbach.
Zephyr Noak.
Michael Paulson.
Brittany Lee Bruland.
Isaac Ferber.
Corey Bolin.
Jacob Kinzer.
Lucy Hescock.
Autumn Semenik.
Kilrain Kalapana.
Peyton Cox.
Tyler Hart.
Austin Hart.
Ali Cobb.
Robert Ross Mims.
Ryan Marvin Cruz.
Stephanie Ann Redding.
Mariah Dolph.
Eileen Andrea Davidson.
Jalen L. Mawali Tele.
Braden Ivy.
Kahu Ikalani.
Austin Paul Gutierrez.
Aura Holoa Span.
Claudia Avalos Crozier.
Raleigh Foster.
Abigail Elena Kroom.
Annalise Sine Lockhart.
Kisaya Zumbra.
Julissa Garcia Perez.
Orion Lada.
Sophia Rose Mottweiler.
Elijah Miller.
Justice Ty Martinez.
Offer Vanderhoff.
Samuel Aladici Walgambi.
Haley Charlene Marsden.
Annabelle Winningham.
Patrick Reining.
Benjamin Philip Hamlin.
Melvin Wanyan Niles.
Johnny William Krell.
Zeta Edgerly.
Evan Willer.
Connor Watson.
Amanda K. Dorlark.
Sage Gallino.
Ren Perot.
Stephanie Taylor Russell.
C.A. Krieger.
Amber Larson.
Diana Trueblood.
Nikki Monique Martinez Salinas.
Jessica Isabel Buenrestro.
Sunshine E. Simmons.
Ali Campbell.
Bridger Reidenauer.
Raina Frampton.
Congratulations. Amaya Karakaburu.
Blair Christine Hickok.
James Theron Wilhite.
Jackson Ruiz.
Madeline Fox.
Saluk Charamath Wirunga.
Dominique Alexander Raymond Rosano.
Caleb McDonald.
Brenda Nieto Rosas.
Tabitha Rose Joaquim.
Colin Murray Orser.
Candace Francis.
Dylan Clausen.
Rhiannon Wright.
Luna Auer Sears.
Taryn Zlotta.
Svetlana Starodubtseva.
Jessica Harris.
Yulia Adeline Graham.
Stephanie Wallen.
Margaret Giddens.
Keenan Johnson.
Maxwell Huney.
Olivia Nordgarden.
John Fleischley.
Logan Habib.
Cole Brown.
Corey Dubois.
Angelica Liana Pedraza.
Jillian Rose Mullins.
Edward Ingalls Colcard.
Amelia Wild.
Sarah Kate Edwards.
Brennan Croy.
Wesley Daniel Joseph Scott Sr.
George Joseph Holquin III.
Nehemiah Albert John.
Carly Harris.
J.
Johnny Bench.
Tiffany Aguilar.
Dulce Diaz Trejo.
Christian Collis.
Gabriel Pontes.
Elliot Evans.
Alhana Scheel.
Gabriel Wayne Ellis.
Catherine Grace Napier.
Josie Lamian.
Karen Ramos.
Kayla Rothless Berger.
Hannah Rubel.
Graduates. As you embark on this new journey, I challenge you to be bold, be curious, and be compassionate. Use your experience to make a positive impact on the world. Be leaders, innovators, and advocates for change. On a final note about community, I want to remind you of the importance of community. You are leaving behind a community that has supported you, challenged you, and helped you grow. While we are still here to cheer you on, you are also entering into new communities that will do the same. Don't forget the lessons you have learned here at Lane and bring them with you as you join new communities. Be an active member in those communities and make a positive impact on those around you. Congratulations, the members of the class of 2023. You have accomplished great things, hard things, extraordinary things, and you're going to accomplish even more. I wish you happiness, fulfillment, health, and prosperity in the days to come. Members of the graduating class, in accordance with the recommendation of the faculty and the authority vested to me by the Board of Education here at Lane Community College and the State of Oregon, I am proud to confer upon you your degree or certificate. Graduates, you may now transfer your tassels from the right side of your cap to the left side of your cap. And this is a symbol of your attainment of your degree or certificate. Family, friends, and guests, I now present to you the Lane Community College Class of 2023. I declare these proceedings to be now closed. Thank you all for joining us today for this celebration.